This is an auto-narrated audiobook generated by Google. Book, Our Partnership with God. Author, Orison Swett Marden. Topic, Our Partnership with God. The nearer we are to omnipotence, the greater our strength. Life will take on new meaning, greater dignity, a higher power when we live in constant realization of or at-one-ment with our Creator, our at-one-ment with the One, our partnership with the All Good. When Christ emphasized the fact that the kingdom of heaven is within us, he meant that this kingdom within is identical with the great cosmic intelligence of the universal mind, and that here we tap the source of all supply. The kingdom that is within us is the kingdom of power. It is in the great within of us that we make wireless connections with omnipotence, with omniscience, with omnipresence. Here's where we actually feel the pulsation of the allness and the everywhereness of God, and are conscious of our connection with the One, our oneness with the All Good. The greatest discovery of the centuries is the discovery of the identity, the oneness of the mind in our subconscious selves, with the great universal mind, the cosmic intelligence. What discovery in 20 centuries, says Dr. Abel T. Allen, compares with this, that man has learned to tap the universal mind, the infinite reservoir of his own soul, and thereby create health, ability, character, or any other quality he may desire. The idea that man can control and adapt to his own growth and enlargement the cosmic intelligence which flows to him through his subconscious self, that by his own power of choice and will this cosmic, creative intelligence everywhere present can be utilized by man as a creative force, is one of the most astounding truths that has ever come to the human mind. Years ago, Henry Ward Beecher said that thinking is creating with God. Yet how few of us realize even today that we cannot think without creating, and that if we think helpful thoughts, unselfish thoughts, love thoughts, we are creating with God. The new thought of God takes God into partnership, and when we realize the divine cooperation in our lives, we think as we, not I. This new thought of God gives us a new conception of man and of his relation to his God. It teaches us that we are a vital, inseparable part of deity, that we are a part of the great creative mind, and that we are creating every day because we cannot think, we cannot feel, we cannot act without creating something. The new philosophy of life teaches us that there is something in man that is inviolable, something that was never born and will never die, something that cannot be contaminated, that cannot sin. It teaches us that there is a divinity within us which is never impaired, that no matter what happens to the rest of us, this divinity, the God in us, is untarnished, inviolable. A human being's power depends very largely upon his God consciousness, upon his conscious partnership with his Creator. The closer the relation, the closer the man's God consciousness, the consciousness of his oneness with the One, the more power he can express, because he draws upon the limitless resources of his infinite partner. Many people seem to have an idea that the creative intelligence out of which everything we know has been created was, in the beginning, localized somewhere in a Creator's mind, but we now know that this great creative intelligence or force is everywhere. We know that it exists in every cell in our bodies and in every created object. Just as the entire man with all the traits and characteristics of his ancestors, and with his own possibilities and his own destiny, was wrapped up in the microscopic protoplasm which unfolds into the full-grown man, so the future lily, the rose, the tree, the fruit, the vegetable, lives in the apparently unorganized protoplasmic germ from which it started. In these microscopic germs, creative intelligence dwells. Every atom, every electron in the universe is the home of the divine intelligence which creates and sustains all things. This intelligence is not fragmentary in the atom or electron, any more than certain parts of the oak are fragmentary in the acorn. The whole of the mighty oak lives in possibility in the acorn. There is nothing added to the oak, which was not an amplification of the cell life in the acorn. What the soil, the chemistry of the sun, the moisture and the atmosphere have added to it were mere helps to the unfolding of the germs in the acorn. What is true of the oak, or any other created thing, is true of man.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.